Give her praise and worship on. Hey. Yes. Come on, y'all. Y'all gotta give praise and worship sometimes. Encourage yourself.
Is anybody here to bless his name?
Yeah.
Let you guys in on a little bit of praise and worship. By the way, I am a Millionaire Hatcher with the Misfits International Ministries. Check us out. If you've never watched us before, please go back to our first video on May 20th and check us out so we can kind of give you an overview of what this ministry consists of. So, Misfits International Ministries, I want you guys to subscribe, like, and share. I'm trying to calm down on my praise and worship high, so forgive me. Let me turn the music down a little bit, because you just get excited sometimes when you just go back and think about all the things that God has brought you through. So I just wanted you guys to have a little praise and worship with me today, you know, encourage some people, because I feel like there's some people that just have become, you know, just so mundane and just the same thing over and over, you know, just the same cycle. So sometimes you have to just, you know, praise and worship, encourage yourself, speak to yourself, speak the word of God over your life. So I want to jump on before I have to go into the Walmart, because I'm always shopping every week. I'm always in the grocery store. I mean, when you have four children and, you know, and your husband, you know, they eat the whole house up. So I'm always in the grocery store. So I just want to jump on and make a quick video because I was preparing. I normally like to clean my fridge out every week before I grocery shop, you know, just clean and freshen up and, you know, get some old stuff out before I bring in the new. So I was just speaking with God this morning, and, you know, I just had some, you know, some prayer requests, and then God told me, hey, meet me at the fridge. So I'm like, okay, you know, I told you, Holy Spirit, you know, speak to me, show me visions, give me those funny visions, because God know, you know, he knows my personality. He knows I'm a quirky individual. He knows I'm goofy and, you know, So, you know, he created me, so he knows me very well. So he told me, meet me at the fridge, because God, you know, like he said, you know your child. So I'm like, okay, God, you know, I'll clean my fridge out before I go grocery shop. So I started to do my norm, you know, get my water ready, you know, Clorox water, the soap, the whole nine yards, taking out stuff out the fridge and going through everything to make sure it's nothing old in there that needs to be, you know, thrown out. And Holy Spirit was speaking to me and he was saying, hey, unfortunately, you know, this is what a lot of people are going through. When is the last time, you know, they've cleaned out their fridge? And I was like, okay, Holy Spirit, you know, you own something, you know, Jesus spoke in parables and Holy Spirit just kind of speaks to me in that way. So I just kind of prayed and I'm like, okay, God, you know, hey, you got to expound on that. Let me know what that means. So he said, hey, go through your fridge and I guarantee you it's going to be something that you either missed, something that you should have thrown out a long time ago, which has been hidden or fell, you know, in the back or something. And it should have been out of the fridge. You know, it's taking up space. We don't have time for that. You have too much stuff, too much new stuff he's trying to bring in. So I go through my fridge and I'm taking out everything and I'm getting, you know, getting ready to clean and wipe, you know, wash down and all that stuff. So I actually found some yogurts, that had, you know, that should have been thrown out a couple of months ago, but they fell all the way, you know, to the back where I couldn't really see them. And I was, you know, I just started laughing. I'm like, okay, God, you know, you're always right. And you know, there's not a certain way that God has to speak to you or speak to people. God can speak to, you know, anyone, however he chooses to. So don't despise it. You know, he can speak through a rock. If he want to speak through a 2-year-old, you know, he can do that. You know, just like he spoke through the donkey when the donkey was trying to, you know, warn Balaam. But Balaam went to beating on the donkey and abusing him to where God allowed the donkey to speak to tell Balaam, like, hey, don't beat on me. I'm trying to warn you. There's an angel, you know, that's standing there blocking us. So, you know, sometimes we would do that. Sometimes we would despise the way that God chooses to speak to us. Because I hear it in the spirit. Some people say, what? Meet you at the fridge. That just doesn't make sense. Hey, sometimes God just doesn't do the things that we expect him to do. He doesn't do it the way we expect it. So we have to start having that open mind and stop putting God in the box. We have to think about, you know, the bigger picture. We can't just have this small mind frame, you know, this one track mind. Because God is not, he's not that type of God. He's not a God of restrictions. So we have to stop doing that. He's an unlimited God. He can do all things. He's powerful. He's magnificent. He's awesome. So I just want to get on and say, when is the last time you cleaned out your fridge? Something to think about. Because not many people clean out their fridge on the regular. And I'm not just speaking, you know, in the physical. I'm speaking about spiritually. When is the last time you cleaned out your spirit, your soul? Get that junk out of there that should have been gone well before, a long time ago. That negative stinking thinking, as George Myers would say, get some of those negative bondages and strongholds. Let's get healed and delivered those old mindsets. It's time to put on the new mind of Christ. We have the mind of Christ, so we have to start thinking in a new way. We got to clean our temple. We got to, you know, we got to get rid of some things out of our life if we want something new and afresh from God. New wine into new wineskins is a word for someone today. I know this word is going to bless many because the Holy Spirit told me so. So I just want to get on and say, hey, go clean your fridge. Go meet God at your fridge. Talk to him. Pray to him while you're cleaning your fridge out. Get rid of some of that old stuff so he could bring in the new. It's time for newness. Like I said before, it's Jolly July. The month has not ended yet. If he chooses to do something on the very last day of the month of July, then praise God. Because there's no restrictions. There's no time. You know, God can do it at the very last minute. And that's what he normally does sometimes. I know for my life, you know, he's done that, you know, quite a few times where he'll wait to the very last minute to do something or bring the blessing forth. So again, go clean your fridge out. Go talk to God. Talk to the Holy Spirit. Let him tell you something new. Get that old stuff out. Let's break off those negative strongholds and bondages off our life. Meet God at the fridge today. Clean it out. Put on, you know, take off those old, those dead, you know, the dead weights. You know, we got to take it off. Got to take that stuff off, out of our mind, out of our soul, our spirit. Let's get healed from wounds. There's so much that we're dealing with, you know, nowadays, and I get it. It's a lot, you know, it's a lot of uncertainty, but we have to, you know, allow God to complete his work in us. We have to do that. We're taking off those old grave clothes and we're putting on the garments of praise today. So turn some music on, play your praise and worship, encourage yourself, do something new today. Do something new today. Speak to God in a different way today. So go clean your fridge out, because I'm getting ready to go grocery shopping. Unfortunately, I have to do that every week. So I got rid of my old stuff and now I'm going to get the new stuff. So let God do that for you today. I hope this word blesses many, because I feel the Holy Spirit said someone and many needed to hear this word. Again, this is Millionaire Hatcher with Misfits International Ministries. Please subscribe, like, and share this word, because it's going to bless someone today. And I just pray that everyone has a blessed, you know, weekend, and let God, you know, do something major in your life today. Again, this is Misfits International Ministries, where we want to see you saved and filled with the Holy Spirit. Thank you guys for watching us. Until next time, love you guys. Bye.